We got a 2004 Mitsubishi Montero Sport. We got a crack in the radiator right here. The radiator shot. We got to take the radiator out and put a new radiator in. All right, we got two clamps, two right here. Clamp right here, and a couple bolts right here, and then there's a shroud, some bolts right here, and then there's a hose like this on the bottom, and then probably two radiator hose, two automatic transmission fluid metal hoses on the bottom. All right, so I got the radiator for about $150 at Discount Auto Parts. I bought new hoses and a cap and another hose for the bottom. So everything all together, I bought brand new. It's about $200. So now I'm gonna go ahead and take this whole unit out and put a new one in, replace the hoses, the clamps, and everything. All right, the first thing you wanna do is line it up, make sure it's about the same size if it looks like the one you're gonna take out. So I'm just gonna eyeball it. The same width, that looks cool. It's got line, the cap lines up, the top hose lines up, the two mounts line up, and then the shroud mounts line up. I think we got the right part. That's pretty cool. I priced this radiator and it went from $150 to $530, depending on who you call. So it pays to shop around. Look at that. So let's take the shroud out first. I'll take this off first, then I'll take these off, and then I'll take these off. Are you recording that? Oh, it's come right off. That. And take the hose off. And now I'm gonna undo this stuff right here, these two guys, for the shroud thing. Radiator has come out first, and this will come out second. That's probably what's gonna happen. That's the last oil place change that didn't tighten it very much at all.
Are you recording right now?
Yeah. For reference. And they need to put this back together.
How cool is that? That is the best news all day. See that? Just a regular little guy that comes out. Nice. Okay, here's the underneath side of it. You just got two little regular clamps. You get to put some pliers on there or channel locks, squeeze those suckers together, yank it off, and it'll go right on. In theory, it should go right on.
You could. Yeah. Grab the other light.
Okay, hold on.
He's on the bottom. It came out from the underneath. It's got these two little lips that kind of just fit right inside the bottom. What you do is you reach your hand down in there and you kind of punch it out a little bit like that. Set it on top of your intake. Undo your hose on the side. Just lifts right out. That. There you go. And that piece is right here. It fits right in the lip right there. Just like that. You gotta lift it up and just pull it out. Everything lines up. Oh, you gotta take your boots off. I'm sure these come off somehow. I think these come off and they sit inside. Like a twitch or something? Or not. Anyways, that lines up. That lines up. Peacock. Got my screws there. Oh, look, it's already on. Sweet. I don't have to take that off. I don't have to touch it. I just gotta pull my hose off. Actually, I bought new hoses. I'm not gonna touch that. We're ready to rock, man. Gotta get this plastic piece off right here. And then we're rolling. The shroud.
Right here. And also on the other side.
good. Alright, one thing you want to remember to get is boots on the bottom, like stabilizers. They keep the thing from rattling around and coming apart. They just pop. They're kind of hard. You have to pop them off, screwdriver.
Put them on the new one. Okay. This has to sit right down inside there. There you go. I'm gonna put the top brackets on first because when I go underneath to put them hoses on the bottom, I'm really gonna be pushing hard. And if I'm pushing hard on this thing on the bottom, it's just gonna flop around inside here. See it flopping? We want to reduce floppage by installing the flange. So you could say it's anti-flopping flange. All right, there you go. Pretty good.